subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
Something different seems to be happening in the Congress. Its state leaders, its state chief ministers seem to be asserting themselves on national issues, which is something that the party has not seen so far. With its top leadership, its top command, essentially directionless, whimsical, as always, the burden now seems to be on its state leaders to put forth their views and put forth the party's stand as far as important national issues are concerned. From Ashok Gehlot to Bhupesh Baghel and Amrinder Singh, all these state chief ministers have now come to the forefront to talk about issues like Love Jihad and the farm laws that the Modi government recently passed. In fact, this trend now seems to be something that may become the new normal for the Congress, given how these state leaders are strong, are mass leaders in their own right, whereas the top leadership of the party is often absent, is often silent. Let's first talk about the top leadership of the party and the kind of problems we've seen with them before moving on to how these chief ministers seem to be coming out of the shadow of the party's top brass. Well, we know Rahul Gandhi has not been party president for a while now, and while Sonia Gandhi might be working president, the party is yet to have a permanent head. Now, this has led to a lot of flux in the party, this has led to a lot of confusion in the party, and the fact that the Congress is sinking is something for everybody to see, sinking nationally rather. I don't think the Gandhis quite realize that this is no longer about the survival of the Congress, but it's about their own survival. Why do I say that? Well, essentially because given that it's not, doesn't seem like the party will come to power at the center anytime soon, and that it's losing state after state, the power of the Gandhis is waning. On their own, Rahul Gandhi already lost from family bastion Amethi in the 2019 Lok Sabha elections, and if things continue this way, it's possible that he may not win a seat in 2024. I'm just giving a possibility, something that might happen. On the other hand, it doesn't seem like Sonia Gandhi will contest Raebareli anymore, and that is a seat that could go as well. This could leave the Gandhis with absolutely no Lok Sabha seat between them. On the other hand, the SPG cover has also been withdrawn. So essentially what the Gandhi family is clutching on to are some fragments or some straws of power from the past, which really at this point leads them nowhere. On important issues, they don't seem to talk because these become uncomfortable issues, whether it was the Babri demolition verdict, which I've talked about earlier, or now whether it's the issue of Love Jihad. In fact, the UP government has now cleared an ordinance to that effect. Karnataka and Madhya Pradesh, all these governments which are led by BJP are talking about bringing a law against Love Jihad, and yet Rahul and Priyanka Gandhi seem to be silent on this front. But silence on these certain issues is just symbolic of the larger malaise in the party. We know how the top leadership now appears to be whimsical, erratic, directionless, and completely unaccountable. And that is the big problem. That is the problem that the Congress needs to solve. Having said that, this is the kind of vacuum that has been created and which is actually making these state leaders come to the forefront. Now, what we've seen in the Congress has been this culture of let the Gandhis speak first. Always the Gandhis first. That seems to be changing. Ashok Gehlot, in fact, in a series of tweets, much needed tweets, asserted against the BJP's worldview or the RSS BJP ecosystem's worldview of Love Jihad. This was much needed. This is precisely what an opposition should do if their rival is pushing forth, howsoever powerful that rival might be, is pushing forth a foolish but dangerous concept like this. And in fact, Ashok Gehlot did well to speak for his party and for himself by asserting against this concept. Bhupesh Baghel, who is Chhattisgarh chief minister, followed suit and also questioned this entire idea behind Love Jihad. Amrinder Singh, of course, we know he is what he always has been, outspoken. He made quite a statement when he joined the farmers' protest against the farm bills, against the farm laws in Delhi. He also has said he will not allow the CBI to enter his state under his watch. So essentially, all these leaders are now coming out of the shadow of the Gandhi family and speaking for themselves. It's not as if the Congress has not had strong state leaders in the past. Of course it has, whether it was Sheila Dixit in Delhi, in the north, or Tarun Gogoi, who unfortunately recently passed away. in Assam in the east, or someone like YSR in Andhra Pradesh in the south. The Congress has had strong state leaders, but the party, particularly the Gandhis, have maintained a system where these leaders remain confined to their states. They speak on state issues, they work on cue from the high command, and the Gandhis, of course, always hold exclusive domain about taking on the ruling party at the center. This is the paradigm that now seems to be changing. I've always argued that for the Congress to be able to resurrect itself from the kind of mess it is in right now, from the kind of free fall it is in right now, it needs to do it state by state, riding on the shoulders of its entrenched, of its popular state leaders like Amrinder Singh, Bhupesh Baghel or Ashok Gehlot, or the younger lot, whether it is Sachin Pilot or the other young leaders. And with the interventions on national issues of significance, these state chief ministers may have just shown the right way for the Congress to emerge from this deep abyss it seems to have been in. For more, log on to our website, theprint.in, to read my column, Politrics.